How's everybody doing today? I'm Matthew DeBlasio.
I'm Chris Keeston.
I'm Patrick Olson.
And I'm Tony Oliver.
And we are also looking to solve the problem of how might we improve the health and well-being of students here at Notre Dame.
For group 6, by the way.
Yeah, group 6. So it's not obvious. Whoa. All right, don't look.
That's not good.
Sorry.
Shit. Fix the technical difficulties. Did not go again. I just clicked it. Alright. Was it good? We're gonna present it, don't worry. Here is how might we improve the health and well-being of students in Notre Dame. And just a little background on myself and my teammates here. We're all student athletes here at Notre Dame. So we thought that a common problem among ourselves as student athletes to start was the mental health as being a priority. Basically, being a student athlete, you don't really worry about the physical part because you are trained to be physically fit. But mainly, we were more concerned with how are our fellow student athletes dealing with these high stress levels that they get put under between academics and performing well in competitions and basically just trying to perform at your best all the time while even being tired and being put under immense amounts of pressure. So just to lead off, this is a little video about my own team. I'm a swimmer here and so is Patrick over here, and this is basically a day that we go through.
Shake 'em up, pull 'em in a circle of homies and watch 'em run up with the 7-7.
thinking that. I don't know what I'm thinking about.
So, as you can see,
obviously, it's a pretty rigorous schedule that most student athletes go through here, on top of having to like pay attention in class and whatnot. So, anybody have these?
So how can we figure out who our target user was? We really wanted to talk to student athletes. I'm looking at the list of questions to ask them, and these are general questions, just asking about their experience as a student athlete in Notre Dame, things they enjoyed, things that cause a lot of stress, and we were really surprised with the candid responses we were getting. A lot of the themes were success as a student athlete is measured in terms of, you know, metrics in classroom, metrics on the court, in the field, in the pool, in the track, et cetera. And one common thing that we noticed is that a lot of high anxiety points throughout the day were practice. You know, look, everyone had four guys on game day, but practice caused a lot of student athletes a lot of stress. And another thing that was very stressful was the exam day. So, one particular question that we got all interesting responses from was, what parts about your sport is going to stress you out? And have a little video interview.
All right. Cool. So, what parts about your sport do you stress you out?
Take you through our journey map, which we were able to do thanks to our ethnographic interviews. We all had our opinions about our highs and lows of the day, but we wanted to represent the athletic community well enough for us to at least come up with our ideas, start with our prototypes, and we were able to do that with our interviews. And surprisingly, most of our athletes that we interviewed all touched on the same highs and lows, very similar. So to begin, our day, probably the worst part of most student athletes that happens way too often is waking up for morning practice. Which is the first low of the day. It's just a terrible thing to start off with a low. Now, the first high, which a lot of people agreed on, is
the really a great highlight of the day is breakfast.
All the freshmen do the entire breakfast. I don't think there's any skips on it. Because, you know, it's in some point. It's like, oh, well, I'll be 9 o'clock, but we'll finish this.
Just a great time to relax and finally prepare yourself for the day ahead of you. Then,
it's 5 a.m. We're at the Oakland airport. We need to go back to South Bend. We got Margaret here. Looks like she's doing some work. Margaret, tell me about all the work that you have coming up next week.
It's the traveling aspect of being a student athlete, which we all love competing, but it really throws out the balance of being a student and an athlete at the same time. Another high is in class, innovation design. And then we move on to our social media skill.
Yeah, so going off of that, we wanted to see, you know, what else was being said out there. And so we looked to social media. And yeah, one thing was, Twitter is a student athlete problem account with 78,000 followers. So it's a big deal. Like, you know, it's not just us in the Notre Dame bubble that are experiencing these pressures, but, you know, everyone's feeling the same way. And you can just notice it by they have multiple tweets a day, like just of anything going on, like something that, you know, makes them stress or what's going on wrong. So that's another thing that we kind of drew on is just seeing what everyone else is saying about it. Also, Pinterest. You know, a common quote is, oh, you're tired, you know, how do you think I'm feeling today? You know, it's like 6 a.m. practices. So it's just a lot of other things that people are saying about it on social media. Same thing, Pinterest. It's like choosing on what you want to do well in. It's almost like you don't have so much time in the day to work and do well everything that you want to accomplish. So just the common problems that we keep seeing. And then next, you know, based on the interviews and the journey maps and our own feelings and in social media, we try to come up with just two mainstream personas that we can focus on. Both deal with high stress. One is that's a picture of Lolo Jones, and she's probably the most well-known track and field athlete that doesn't have an Olympic medal. So basically, she was put under the immense stress to, you know, accomplish something. And she was in first place, and she hit that hurdle in the Olympics finals, and she got fourth because of that. So she's one of the personas where you have a high stress level and you just let it get to you and you don't perform that you want to. The opposite of that would be high stress level Michael Jordan, you know, always having to repeat, you know, everyone's out to get him every season, and he just always comes up and hits the shot. So that's the other side of the coin is being able to manage the stress. So we want to take almost that first persona of someone who's just going to let the stress get to him and, you know, bring him to the Michael Jordan type of stage.
To first attack our problem that we figured out, we all came up with our own prototype of an idea to pursue. And they all served as foundations of our final solution. But the first one was an academic course to set up a class and helping manage such things that a student athlete goes through in their daily life. Another prototype that we came up with was an interactive calendar, because organization is just key in improving the student athlete life. So we felt interactive calendar that worked with you rather than you controlling the whole thing really would help to assist the stress levels. Next, this is a super stress ball in which you can follow yourself, maybe determine which points of the days you squeeze it the most to see which levels, when your stress is the highest during the day. Very simple idea, but it really goes to show that simplicity can't be ruled out. And then last prototype we came up with was an anonymous text service. So any problems that you have during the day, anything that goes on, you just text it and it does the best it can to try and help you out. On the feedback.
So we went out and asked feedback of our prototype, and we conducted two surveys asking our users what they thought about the prototype. value prototypes, and the stress, the interactive calendar and the stress management seminar were both scaled the highest, and we decided to intertwine those two for our final prototype. And overall, some of the feedback that we got, people thought that the class might not be implementable just because it would be hard to kind of get a class past the university that would be only for athletes. You had to figure out whether the class would be offered for a grade, whether it would be offered pass fail, things like that. While people weren't too big of fans of stress ball, they said themselves that they wouldn't use it. Another thing of the calendar, Scott was saying it kind of works similar to Sakai, and people thought that it would be too expensive to implement. So as I said, we decided to go with this final solution of implementing the social interactive calendar and kind of encompassing that in our final class solution.
All right, we're going to do a little demonstration right now. I'd like to call Professor Angst up to the stage.
You guys are picking at me today.
And so basically what we're going to try and do during our academic course is simulate a lot of different things that are going to help out our student athletes a lot. So right now, what I want you to do is throw this ball in between Patrick's arms. But before you do that, remember, this is the fourth time you've been in the national championship game and you are a senior. You haven't won all 3 years before, okay? You are taking your last foul shot to win the game. It's one shot, win or lose. There's no time in this game, okay? I want everyone to start cheering, Wendy, Wendy, Wendy. Oh no, that wasn't supposed to happen. Alright. So basically throughout the entire course we would have a bunch of different like class days where we would perform different types of simulations and stuff that would help student athletes, I guess, manage all of these types of game, not just game time, that was just the game time simulation. That would be one class. And then we would go into how we would give you a bunch of different exercises on how to manage that and keep your composure during a really high pressure like game, especially because we want to be Michael Jordan. We don't want to be like Lolo Jones. We wanted to talk more about
the
class
as well. And also, like, just about the class. So this class will be required by all freshman athletes to take, and basically for freshman athletes in Notre Dame, they would take a personality survey, and based on their responses, they would be grouped together. So athletes facing similar stresses or facing similar issues would be grouped together. And this would work out because freshmen, at least first semester freshmen, don't pick out their classes to begin with. So athletes would take this class either first or second semester, and it would replace contemporary topics that we have to take. It would be 8 weeks long, and it would be as a pass-fail class. And the class would be led by administrator. As you guys can see, like in your syllabus, and as Matthew was talking about, each week a different lesson. We touched on to this game time simulation that we did. It's just one aspect of the class, but we focus on things like nutrition, stress management, and particularly the innovative interactive social calendar that we talked about in one of our prototypes. During the first week of the class, you would actually work to set up this calendar. And as we talked about before, but basically this calendar, it would link up all your meetings, all your assignments, from the beginning to the end of the semester, and it would be interactive, so we could view each other's assignments, we could view each other's meetings, so, you know, no longer could you tell someone that, oh, you know, you weren't busy, because you could just look on the calendar and see that they actually, you know, did have something to do. The class would be led by an administrator in the athletic department, so whether it be Mike Parody or Missy Conway, I figured out it was just behind that, and then each week, a professional in the athletic administrator would be invited to kind of guest teach class, so might be the sports nutritionist or like the sports psychologist. And then also we would invite a senior captain from each team just to make it more real life and more realistic. And just one thing about this class that differentiates it than contemporary topics One thing that we got from a lot of our users was that contemporary topics students took selection to, and they wanted a class that was very much engaging, interactive, so that you're getting it and you're actually performing a lot of things. And with this class, like I said, it would be pass-fail, and each week you would have a reflective assignment, so you couldn't just show up to class and, you know, get a grade deduction, perform some kind of like engagement afterwards. So, like I said, a lot of people enjoyed this as one of our final solutions. And in speaking with some of the administrators, I guess some of the problems that might accompany this solution is just making this class specifically just for student athletes. We're working to kind of combine it with contemporary topics, so maybe athletes take it like the last 8 weeks of the semester, and maybe non-athletes can take it at the beginning of our semester. But overall, we think that this is the best solution to combat stress that companies have.
That's it. Open
the
floor for any questions.
You guys had a great use of video to help articulate your point. I thought that was well done. So for the class, so you said it would replace the contemporary topics that freshmen would currently take, so the athletes would just take a different class.
Well, as of right now, the athletes, like, contemporary topics is like I think it's a third of semester of in-class stuff, and then it's two-thirds of the semester of two different sports. So as of right now, the athletes still need to do the two-thirds of the semester of those parts. But we're saying instead of having this other, like, one-third, we would do an athlete class instead of that.
Okay. And the feedback from the athletes you spoke with on the class, people were supportive and would prefer?
They felt that it would be very helpful, more so because we're coming into school, like everyone else, just the transition is huge to become a college student. And we come in as a college student, not only to balance college student, but also with our athletic overload. So they all felt that was a good way to, like, start out, and actually any type of problem that may arise, we evaluated, took the most important problems we felt, and basically each class is tackling each problem how best to do it, whether it's through learning skills or just gaining more awareness of how to manage each, whether it be stress or a healthy lifestyle, confidence, positivity, any of those.
And just going off of that, so like I said, so before the freshman enter, Paul did take this personality survey, so this specific syllabus you guys is for like a certain group of athletes or that are going through things based on their responses. So like the course would be tailored to whatever the group of athletes need. So like it wouldn't be standardized like the current contemporary topics class is. So that is one thing that makes it different than other classes.
Did you notice any differences between gender or discipline, the sport?
Well, amongst the girls, as far as
their preferences and things that they're more passionate about with the project?
Yeah, well, especially with the girls I interviewed, they particularly like this just because part of them, like, really stress, and part of them kind of feeling better about themselves and kind of just them, like, talking and sharing their feelings with other people. I can't really say the same for the guys, so I think that amongst the female student athletes, this was
I would say the males, just because we have too much pride, don't want to admit that, like, yeah, we need help, but a lot of, like, the males that we interviewed felt that it would be a lot better than contemporary topics, and I'm sure they felt that it would help them out.
What was cool is, like, when we're all different sports up here, it's like, so we have three different sports, so we thought maybe one sport's going to be more stressful than the other, it's going to be really different. Then what we got was pretty much we all hit the same points. And that was, like, the cool thing was once we found that out, the first interviews, we're like, okay, we can do something, like, with all of them easily.
All right. Thank you, guys. Good job.